Hello friends, welcome back. Today in this video we will be working on a new sensor which is an analog to digital converter, and that is MCP3426. So for more info about this sensor, let's go to controleverything.com and here search for our sensor, that is MCP3426. Here it is. It is a 16-bit 2-channel analog to digital converter, and some of its more important features are mentioned here. You can also buy this sensor from here. Now today we will be interfacing this sensor with an Arduino Nano, and for that we need a code. So click on source tab and here you will find the Arduino code sample for MCP3426. Click on it and you can download all the codes from here as a zip file. You can also download the same code from our GitHub repository, which is Control Everything Community. Now we need some hardware for interfacing. Let's move on to that part. In the hardware connections part, what do we require is an Arduino Nano. And this here is an Arduino Shield. It is available on the website controleverything.com and you can purchase it from there. The reason we are using this is to make easy connections with other I2C devices. So gently place Arduino over this I2C shield and make a connection like this. Now we require to power up our Arduino Nano, and for that we need a mini USB cable just like this. Insert it in the power jack of the Arduino Nano. This is our sensor MCP3426 and this is a connecting cable. Connect the sensor with connecting cable like this, and while making connection, make sure the brown wire of the cable should be connected to the ground of the sensor. And the same rule applies to the I2C shield. And with this, we are done with the hardware part. Now let's move on to the interfacing and working of the sensor. For the interfacing of the sensor, first of all we have to log in to github.com, and here we have to search for the community, that is Control Everything Community. Here we have to search for the sensor, that is MCP3426. Here is our sensor and here is the Arduino code. But first let's check the instructions. We have to download and install the Arduino software on our machine, and steps to install the Arduino software is given on this link. Please go through this link and you can download the Arduino software on various platforms like Windows, Mac and Linux. Please do it carefully. After that, we have to download or git pull the code and double click the file to run the program. Later, we can compile and upload the code on Arduino IDE and we can see the output on serial monitor. So let's get back to the code. This is our Arduino code with .in extension. And this is the code. Firstly, in the code we have included y.h library here, and we have defined the I2C address of MCP3426 here, which is 0x68. In the void setup, we have initialized the I2C communication and set baud rate of 9600 here. In the writing part, we have sent the configuration command 0x10, in which we have selected continuous conversion mode, channel 1 and 12 bit of resolution. Later, we have given a delay of 300 milliseconds here. In while loop, we have selected the data register 0x00 from which we are reading 2 bytes of data, which is raw ADC MSB and raw ADC LSB. After that, we have converted the data to 12 bits according to the formula given in the datasheet of MCP3426. And in the last part, we have output the data to serial monitor through this command. And with this, we are done with the interfacing of sensor. Let's see the working and performance of the sensor. Let's move to that part. For the working of the sensor, first of all we have to copy the entire code. Then we have to open the Arduino software IDE on our machine and then paste it here. Now save the code with the name MCP3426. Now we have to verify and compile our code. It will take a while. It is done compiling. Now upload the code through here. The code is now uploaded. Now we can see the output from serial monitor here. Now you can see the output is almost zero because nothing is connected to the channel 1 of the sensor. But when I connect a 1.5 volt of battery cell, you can see the output 1327. It is almost constant because the cell is connected continuously. So this is how the sensor works. Now let's see the application and features of the sensor. The sensor is a 16-bit analog-to-digital converter with differential inputs. It is a low noise and high accuracy 16-bit delta-sigma analog-to-digital converter. It is the family member of MCP342X series from the Microchip technology. The device can output analog-to-digital conversion results at rate of 1560 or 240 samples per second depending on the user controllable configuration bit settings. The device has two conversion modes, one-shot conversion mode and continuous conversion mode. The application includes portable instrumentation and consumer goods, temperature sensing with RTD and thermocouple, bridge sensing for pressure, strain and force, weigh scales and battery fuel gauges, factory automation equipment and many more like this. This sensor can be purchased from our website, that is controleverything.com. You can download the code from resource type and after that as a zip file. Also, you can have the code from our GitHub repository, which is Control Everything Community. In the end, I would like to clear, if you have any further queries regarding the interfacing and working of the sensor, you can reach us on controleverything.com and you can also post comments on our community page. For articles and blogs on various sensors like this, you can look us on instructable.com and you can subscribe our YouTube channel for more video tutorials like this. In the end, I hope you enjoyed the video and have a good day.